You see, later that year, I was hit by a semi-truck and ended my career. I mean, I was in a car, but it was still. After that, I wasn't doing very well mentally. And honestly, I'm surprised that I lived. That's kind of why I came to St. Stephen's my junior year. And I'm so happy I did. I was given such an incredible opportunity to start over and win my life, where my idea of the future can serve to matter to change. This is all very cliche, and even more cliche to say this cliche, but getting hit by that semi truck was the best thing that's ever happened to me. But that's not really what I want to talk about. You see, our brains are so good at being computers that just react to the situations presented in front of them until everything is crazy. Even when that happens, our brains are was accepting that I'm exactly where I'm supposed to be. Sometimes we can feel really anxious and feel like I should be doing something else, but really in the past year, I decided to tell myself that I'm allowed to grow up, and I'm allowed to make mistakes. Like, no one really has any idea what's going on, and that's kind of comforting. Because I knew so much, I wasn't defined by my peers as who I was, which is so different from the situation a lot of you guys grew up in. As you're navigating through the craziness, try to remember that everyone is entitled to their own growth. If a snake doesn't shed its skin, it dies. So go easy on yourself and go easy on people around you, because no one knows what's happening, and it's all so temporary. So you might as well have fun with the people that matter, because they just want to have fun with you. I just want to thank the people I need to sit in complete silence with, and be completely content, because there's a beauty in it. Dominique, I have a heart of gold, and the thought of being an ocean apart is too much, and I think we both know it has nothing on us. I really want to thank my mom from the bottom of my heart for the sacrifices she has made for me. Thank you so much for guiding my education, and who I am as a person. She's the perfect mom for me. Without you and the kind of love you love with, I would literally not be alive. I won the lottery to have you. You're the most selfless, strong, and understanding person I know. You make me feel grounded, but also like I have wings. You're my best friend, and I don't know what I'm going to do without you next year. Looking back at my journey and all the skins I've shed, what's taught me the most hasn't been from inside the classroom, but the turns I took along the way. My advice to you is to take risks. Sail across the ocean, fly across the country. Talk to strangers, get hit by a semi-truck. Only you can figure out who you are. Don't wait for an opportunity.